Ladies and gentlemen.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us for this evening's Millennium Stage performance in the Terrace Theater, brought to you by Target and the Marriott Foundation. At this time, we ask that you turn off and silence all electronic devices. Photography and video recording are not permitted during the performance. Millennium Stage is a free performance series brought to you at 6 p.m., 365 days a year. All of our performances are live streamed and archived on our website at kennedy-center.org. Tonight, we present a musical journey from Norway to the USA, from folk culture to concert halls. Here to introduce the performance tonight is the Minister-Councellor of Communication and Culture at the Royal Norwegian Embassy, Jon-Age. Please welcome him to the stage.
Thank you and good evening. Yes, indeed, this is a musical journey from Norway to the United States, from traditional folk music to traditional folk music and dance through more contemporary styles. Two of the compositions here tonight are actually made specifically for this occasion, and they will therefore be presented for the very first time. The program will mirror the story of Norwegian immigration to the United States. Apart from Ireland, no other country saw a larger share of its population leave. Today, more than 5 million Americans identify themselves as Norwegian Americans, and that's more than the population in Norway itself. The Norwegian immigrants embraced America and her customs and her values. At the same time, they held on to many of their cultural traditions that they had brought with them across the Atlantic. And tonight's program echoes those traditions. And they also reflect the meeting of two cultures, as at the same time as they show how new impulses were brought into the traditions. So on behalf of the Royal Norwegian Embassy here in Washington, D.C., I would like to thank the Kennedy Center for offering the Millennium Stage for this event. Our long-standing cooperation is much appreciated. I also recognize the financial contributions to this event by Statoil, the Kongsberg Group, and Jiffy International. So, ladies and gentlemen, the program tonight has been put together specifically for this evening, and under the enthusiastic leadership of artistic director and accomplished flute soloist Andreas Sønning, a select group of internationally recognized artists are now standing ready to, in their own way, take you through 150 years of Norwegian-American history. So it is with great anticipation that I can say the four magic words, let the show begin. Enjoy.
Oh,
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to be here in the Kennedy Center of Performing Arts with this wonderful staff that do everything they can for us. So thank you for the invitation. As you have heard now, the concept for this program is a musical journey from Norway to the United States of America, from folk culture to concert halls. The settlers, the immigrants, the poor people coming from Norway to the United States of America in the 1800s, they had this dream that something wonderful should happen. And this is what this poem describes. And this is what inspired the Norwegian composer Kjell Habbestad and was translated by William H. Halvorsen. And both of these gentlemen, they are here today, so let us give them a nice round of applause, wherever you are. Thank you. The immigrants, they brought, as the Minister-Councellor said, they brought their culture, their songs, their stories, the music, the dance. We hope that this will be enjoyable for you to see our presentation of this tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Folk music and classical music have been together in peace in Norway for many hundred years. And we'll now get a tune that I will play first on my Hardanger fiddle, and then we will hear Edvard Grieg's version. It's about a famous fiddle player calling himself Müllerguten. And he was very in love with the girl, but his family didn't have the right status and money. So he had actually to play this in the wedding of this girl with another man.
Thank you. In 1891, the composer and violinist Johan Halvorsen was given this violin, a 1705 Rogeri from Italy, by a wealthy Russian in St. Petersburg. Later in life, he spent much time writing down folk music for the fiddle. You'll hear some examples of that in the second of our pieces. The first piece, however, is a slow, beautiful elegy from one of his theater compositions.
Thank you. Thank you. I don't know whether the Norwegians brought their home brew over to America. It was not legal in Norway anyway. They had to struggle to survive. The pop group A-ha came over in 1985 with a big hit, Take On Me. You remember that? Yes, good. And that was an enormous success. It was top on the Billboard 100. And they were asked for everywhere. They had huge concerts, 80, 90,000 in stadiums. It was great. And I don't think they were fishing or building houses or farming, but they had a great success. One of their friends that worked with them for many years was Kjetil Bjerkestrand. He is a composer, arranger, and he is inspired from that tune, not from a fiddle, not from folk song, but for a pop song, from a pop song. And also, on the original Take On Me, there was a cartoon. Some of you might remember that. And our fiddler, dancer, and composer, Andreas Ljones, has actually drawn a cartoon for this new piece. So this is another world premiere by Kjetil Bjerkestrand, and I'll try to do that. Wish me luck.
Thank you. It's all about to belong somewhere, to belong in a country, in a town, in a house, with someone, without someone. It's all about coming home. We're all going home.
Girl.
Most charismatic figure in the Norwegian music life of the 19th century was definitely the violinist Ole Bull. He was known to pay his audiences to bravo him, and he was also known to make the ladies in the audience faint. He loved to play the Norwegian music, but he also admired very much the European masters, the master violins, particularly the famous Paganini. So we'll play a piece more inspired by the European than the Norwegian.
Thank you.
We have an acknowledged composer in America called Ned Rorem, and we have found out that he has Norwegian ancestors. That makes us proud. And there is a musicologist called Randi Eidsaa of the University of Agder, Norway, and she has studied him, sitting days in the National Library here in D.C., and she has suggested a lot of pieces, and we were happy to choose four of them. And we think that he has Norwegian ancestors also musically, being inspired from the nation and the folk traditions. So, enjoy.
Yet you know not whom I mean.
Reality in life. It is. It's everywhere. And when I go to the theater, I want magic. I want, you know, dreams. I want flowers. I want pink. Heaven. Not this reality thing. Come on. I want magic.
That's what I try to give to people.
turn on that light. He'll look so ugly in that light. Why not see by candlelight? Moonlight. Men never get used to this. Ever. Well, maybe not me neither. Oh, well, you found a place, at least a country. You find a town that you like. Now, where you gonna live? It's hard. All these big issues. It's too loud. It's not the right flat. There's mold. So different things. But once, I really thought I had found the perfect apartment. 14G. 1, 2, 3, 4. I just moved in to 14G. So cozy, calm, and peaceful. Heaven for a mouse like me. With quiet by the blissful. Pets are banned and parties too. There are no solicitations. Window seat with garden view. A perfect nook to read a book. I'm lost in my Jane Austen. Felt good. Oh,
We have the last number. We have a combination of a very popular American tune, Both Sides Now. And you know, with this media situation we have today, so-called Global Village, we all love this song, not just Americans. And we have taken the liberty to do it our way, combining it with our musical expressions from Norway.
Rose and flows are angel hair, and ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons everywhere. I looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, but still somehow it's clouds, illusions.
Thank you.
worries and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. But now old friends, they acting strange. They shake their heads and they say that I've changed. Well, something's lost and something's gained in living